position. Yes, sister, mic number four.
Good evening, sir. My name is Sabina. I'm a student. You gave an example about how we students, the youngsters, shoot an arrow and draw a bullseye. I would just like to make the same sort of allegation to you. You shot an arrow, your arrow, and drew your bullseye. And now if anybody does not aim where you have aimed before, they are wrong. That, I think, is inconsiderate and inhuman.
Sisters asked a very important question. When I gave the example, people shoot in the air and then draw the bullseye. She's saying and alleging, even I have done the same. And if people don't agree, then I don't agree with them. Sister, please tell me, where was my arrow wrong? Which part of my lecture was putting, I gave example that people do graduation. Why do graduation? I don't know. What you will do? I don't know. After passing, what job you'll take? I don't know. I gave example. Now you, sister, give me an example in my lecture. Which part of my lecture was shooting the air, shooting the arrow in the air and drawing a bullseye? If not, then I would tell you that you are shooting in the air and then drawing the bullseye.
But you already said it.
Sister, which part of my lecture? I give you a chance to reply. Which part of my lecture was shooting in the air and then drawing a
bullseye? Your part of the lecture was not shooting in the air.
MashaAllah, thank you very much.
The whole aim was like the, why judging people by defining them on the terms of Islamic and what their purpose in life is only in terms of Islamic.
You give me a better purpose of life. You give me a better purpose. If, see, we are having open question and session, anyone can differ with me. I'm not telling I'm always
right.
Exactly,
people differ from you.
You have the right to differ. But when you differ, you have to give the reason. For example, I say 2 plus 2 is equal to 4. You say, no, it is not 4, it is 5. I'll ask you why. So tell me which part of my lecture, or you tell me, is there any better purpose of life than to thank the Creator, than to worship Him?
There are differences, and you cannot just, you know, convert everyone, convert not in the sense of converting into Islam, converting people's viewpoints. You know, there are differences.
Sister, you are not answering my question. You are beating around the bush.
I'm not
my
beating
question
around
is,
the bush.
What is
That's
the
because
purpose?
You're presuming that you, I will answer whatever you want me to answer.
No, sister.
I'll answer it in my way.
So you are always beating around the bush.
I have heard his answer, mashallah.
So thank you, sister. Thank you for your comments. And we leave the audience to be the judge. How many people will follow you? How many people follow me? We'll come to know later on. So next time when you give a lecture, I hope you get an audience which is big. So then they listen to your answer of purpose of creation, sister.
Hello, sir. I'm Pala Klaelka from NEN Khargar. I'm a student. I just wanted to say something about the person who said, like, first asked you the question about idol worship. I'm a follower of Lord Krishna, and I just remember something that my aunt once told me, and I just wanted to say that it's like when we do idol worship, it's when we see, we have a picture of them, or we can feel them. When you see them, you can actually feel what it is like, and you can praise them. It's what my perception is. So I just wanted to say that related to the first person who asked you to, like, he doesn't know any what he feels about idol worship.
Behan ne sawal kiya hai ki wo Krishna ki pujari hai aur jab bhut parasti karti hai, murti puja karti hai, to murti ka photograph, wo us Ishwar ka photograph rakhti hai, us Ishwar ki murti rakhti hai, taki concentration ke liye, to isiliye wo murti puja karti hai. Behan, आपके हिंदू धार्मिक किताब में लिखा है कि मूर्ति पूजा गलत है, और मैं कई बार कह चुका हूं, फिर से दोहराता हूं, क्या लिखा है श्वेता सेतार उपनिषद में चैप्टर नंबर 4 मंत्र नंबर 19 और यजुर्वेद में अध्याय नंबर 32 मंत्र नंबर 3 में, न तत्स्य प्रतिमा अस्ति, उस ईश्वर उस भगवान की कोई प्रतिमा नहीं, कोई फोटोग्राफ नहीं, कोई पिक्चर नहीं, कोई पेंटिंग नहीं, कोई बुत नहीं, कोई मूर्ति नहीं. लेकिन फिर भी आपके मजहबी किताब में साफ तौर पे लिखा है मूर्ति पूजा गलत है, फिर भी हिंदू धर्म के अधिकारी पंडित मुझसे कहते मैं जब कहता हूं आपकी मजहबी किताब में साफ लिखा है गलत है, क्यों करते आप मूर्ति पूजा, तो वो कहते हैं कि मूर्ति पूजा करते हैं मानते हैं गलत है, लेकिन मूर्ति पूजा करते कॉन्सेंट्रेशन के लिए। जब हम हायर लेवल ऑफ कॉन्शियसनेस पहुंच जाएंगे तो मूर्ति पूजा की जरूरत नहीं, पहले पहले शुरुआत में कॉन्सेंट्रेशन के लिए मूर्ति जरूरत है, हायर लेवल पे हायर कॉन्शियसनेस पे मूर्ति की जरूरत नहीं। तो मैं उनसे कहता हूं, उन पंडितों से और आपसे भी, हम मुसलमान हायर कॉन्शियसनेस पहुंच गए, हमें मूर्ति की जरूरत नहीं। मैं इनसे पूछता हूं कि शुरुआत में कहते हैं कि स्टार्टिंग में जरूरत है बाद में नहीं, जब आप स्कूल में जाते हैं पहली कक्षा में आप बेसिक सीखते हैं, बेसिक सीखते कठिन चीज बाद में सीखते आठवीं नौवीं दसवीं में। तो मैथ्स में अगर कोई कहेगा 2+2=5, आपने कहेंगे गलत है मैं जानता हूं, दसवीं में आऊंगा तो कहूंगा कि 2+2=5, it is 4। आप बचपन में ही कहेंगे भाई 2+2 is the foundation। अगर हर मजहब का फाउंडेशन है कि भगवान की मूर्ति नहीं है, फोटोग्राफ नहीं है, बुत नहीं है, फाउंडेशन ही जब पहले गलत सिखा रहे तो आगे जाके कैसी इमारत बनेगी। तो इसीलिए इन पंडितों से जब मेरा बहस होता है, गुफ्तगु होती है, वो जवाब ही नहीं दे सकते। वो कहते मानता हूं कि हमारी मजहबी किताब में गलत है, लेकिन फिर भी इनिशियली कॉन्सेंट्रेशन के लिए। तो मैं कहता हूं कि हम मुसलमान इनिशियली भी हमें जरूरत नहीं मूर्ति की ना बुत की, हमें हमेशा हक बात कहना चाहिए। और ये साफ तौर पर लिखा है सारी मजहबी किताबों में, चाहे हिंदू मजहब की किताब हो, ईसाई मजहब की, यहूदी मजहब की, इस्लाम मजहब की, मूर्ति पूजा गलत है और हराम है और हमें इससे दूर रहना चाहिए। हमें खुदा की कलाम पे, खुदा के कलाम पे, खुदा के अहकामात पे अमल करना चाहिए, ये दीन के ठेकेदारों के नहीं। अगर आपको लगता है कि जाकिर गलत है, जाकिर को भी छोड़ो, जाकिर इस्लाम में जीरो है। अगर जाकिर वो बात कर रहा है जो खुदा से मिलती है, जो आखिरी पैगंबर से मिलती है, इसीलिए मैं हवाला देता हूं, चैप्टर नंबर वर्स नंबर, इतने हवाले थोड़ी फेंक रहा हूं मैं, आप चेक करो और जाके तहकीक करो, संतुष्ट हो जाएगी तो अमल करो। तो मैंने इतने हवाले दिया हूं बहन, आप मानते हैं कि बुत परस्ती गलत है अभी?
सर आई कंप्लीटली एग्री विद व्हाट यू सेड।
माशाल्लाह, आप अग्री करते हैं लेकिन अमल नहीं करते।
देयर इज अनदर पॉइंट ऑफ इट। So honestly, I am not such a religion follower. I just believe that I have a God, and even today I haven't read many of the books of religion. I've just read Bhagavad Gita, and
when Bhagavad Gita does it say that you have to do idol worship? Sister, yes, I don't want you to be very religious. At least be a little religious. And the basics of religion is that idol worship is haram, idol worship is forbidden. I am asking you where, which chapter, which verse of Bhagavad Gita tells you that you have to do idol worship? Which verse?
Sir, I would like to say the reason I believe in idol worship. It is, when I have a problem, a very big problem, all I do is I close my eyes, visualize and feel my Lord, that is Lord Krishna whom I worship. And it just makes me feel so much better. I get so much strength that I know I'm ready to face anything that comes.
Oh, I will give you the reply. Sister, if you read Bhagavad Gita, chapter number 7, verse number 20, it says that those whose desire has been stolen, those whose desire has been stolen by material things, they do idol worship. Verse number 21 says that if you worship the false god, God will fulfill your wish, you will go to the kingdom of the false god. So Bhagavad Gita says that if you worship false god, he will fulfill your requirements, but you will go to the kingdom of the false god. Same thing is mentioned in the Quran. Allah gives you, even if you worship wrong things, Allah fulfills your desires and you go more into the depths of darkness. So this is, God is testing you, that do you really worship the true God or do you believe in wrong things? If you worship the wrong thing, Allah fulfills your desires and put you more in the depths of darkness. You may think that if you ask an idol for wealth, you get wealth. Wealth will not take you to paradise. Following the commandments of God will take you to paradise. So sister, isn't it mentioned in Bhagavad Gita that don't do idol worship? It says those whose intelligence has been stolen by material desires, they do idol worship. So do you mean, I'm asking you, are you a materialistic person?
I don't think so.
So then why do you do idol worship? You are going against the teaching of Bhagavad Gita.
I get it. I would like to think about it. Thank you, sir.
Go back home, think about it, read the translation of Bhagavad Gita, and I request you to even read the translation of the Quran. Inshallah, you read the translation of the Quran, and inshallah, I will ask the sisters to give an English translation. And if you are satisfied, it will show you the true direction of how a life should be led.
Thank you.
Hope that answers the question, sister.
Yeah.